Jin Woo, if you are ready, then you can start.
Hello, I'm Jin Woo, and I'm going to talk to you about gun control in the U.S. and how it relates to the Second Amendment. So, before we start to talk about what the actual problem is, I'd like to define mass shootings. I'll be using that term a lot. So mass shootings, as we widely agree, are crimes that involve a gun or perhaps even many guns to target a vast number of people to kill or injure. And that gun right up there, it's an AR-15, and it's one of the most prevalent weapons that appear in such crimes because of its killing capacities, because it's actually derived from the M4, which is a very lethal weapon. But these guns aren't actually the problem. The actual problem are these gun parts called bump stocks. So bump stocks, what they do is, when gun companies name guns that are originally military issue and then given to civilians, they remove some of the more deadly features. But these bump stocks enable users to use automatic fire capabilities on these civilian weapons, which greatly increases the number of injured and the number of casualties from these kinds of crimes. So that there is a bump stock, you can use it to sort of hold the trigger in fire. So normally you would ask, why? Why the US, like this vast world power, it's very economically successful, it's a very stable democratic society, why would we have so much kind of crime in the US? It's actually more than any other country in the world. That's a question to answer, but there are various theories to disprove. It's not MS-13, it's not gang warfare, it's not a high number of naturally ill people with guns. It's none of those. It's just that it's in their laws that they can use guns, and a lot of people have decided to use them against their original purpose, to inflict hurt on other people. So I'll just introduce you to some statistics before we start to talk about it. The left one is a cumulative count of shootings up until now, and just because there are a very small number of Muslims who perpetrate these crimes, I want to highlight those blue parts. Those are the Muslim shooters, and it shows that it's not a terrorism issue. At the same time, you can see the clear trend that's happening. There's an increase every year in the number of people who are being shot at and killed or injured. And that just is reiterated in the right one. It's a 12-month moving average, and you can just look at the peaks there because it's basically an annual statistic. And you can see it's increasing very steeply in recent years. To top it all off, I want to introduce you to this graph, and it doesn't even include the Las Vegas shooting. That one is the most deadly of all time. And there are all these different shootings that often involve these like 50 people dead, 53 injured. There's high death tolls, high numbers of injured people, and you can just see how grim they are. So, I was originally going to show you all 22 listings of these shooting, but I'm going to cut it short because it's depressing to watch every single one of those horrible events. So I'll move on to the Second Amendment. So it was in the title. And the Second Amendment originally reads, a well-regulated militia being necessary for the preservation of a free state, the rights of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. So it basically allows them to keep guns, use them for self-defense purposes and other things. It was adopted early on in the history of the US, and these were the original reasons for it being reinstated. So they had to repel invasion, of course. That was a very dangerous era to live in as a country. They had to repel the British, the tyrannical government. They had to have law enforcement officers who could detain criminals, so they gave them firepower. And there are all these good reasons, but they're no longer valid, most of them. So what happened is, in that era, it was a very politically charged era with lots of military conflict, but they had these limited firearms. So at best, they were talking about muskets that fire off one musket ball a minute. But right now, we have all these dangerous weapons that fire off hundreds of rounds in like a few seconds. And that's just not applicable to the current situation. And there are all these people who are not being helped at all by giving us these strange conspiracy theories that liberals are trying to truck down on gun owners by using these fake manufactured captured exodus. I'm not sure if the audio is going to come through, but just a second. Looks like the audio is breaking up, but that was originally some commentary by a far-right commentator who spins these conspiracy theories. And he was talking about how an elementary school shooting in 2012 was completely fake. It was used by the liberals to sort of implement some more restrictions on guns. And that's not helping the current situation at all. So, I've been talking about school shootings a lot, but that's not because I value students' lives above others. We're all equal in life. And the thing I want to talk about is we have designated these schools as areas where students can go, relax, enjoy themselves, learn something safely. But the reality is that they're not safe at all. They're being turned into war zones. We're implementing like smoke systems to ward off shooters. We're putting more and more armed guards on campus. We're talking about giving teachers weapons. We're talking about giving students bulletproof backpacks. And that's just wrong because we have the need to provide safe learning environments for these students. Let's take a look at this spin-off of a nursery rhyme. It's originally a star, but it's been changed to talk about what you should do in a shooting situation, which is pretty grand because this is actually a preschool or first grade classroom, I believe. And the fact that we have to teach them such grim things should be disturbing. And the Parkland shooting, I wanted to bring this up because of the good guy with the gun theory. So the good guy with the gun theory is basically, you have a good guy with a gun who can stop the active shooter. But the fact is, if they're not matched in firepower, they can't do anything. So that's totally disproving of that entire theory. And to wrap it all up, it's all grim, but the best that's come out of this is that students have been more politically active. They've been voicing their opinion on a variety of topics to keep these kinds of things from going on. And it's good, but legislation isn't moving forward. And we need to have some compassion as human beings. We need to stop this trend of death and injury. But again, when at the top of the chain of command you have people who are incapable of using compassion without note cards, it's hard to do so, but still, it would be best if the lawmakers could see through their differences and come to a resolution to stop them crying together. Thank you.